हेलो फ्रेंड्स, दिस इज़ जुबैर खान एंड यू आर वॉचिंग जोराबी नर्सिंग ऑनलाइन क्लासेस। सो टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट अ न्यू चैप्टर दैट इज़ कार्डियोवास्कुलर सिस्टम। सो वी विल डिस्कस अबाउट द व्हाट आर द डिसीज कंडीशन एंड एनाटॉमी, फिजियोलॉजी एंड डायग्नोस्टिक प्रोसीजर, ऑल थिंग्स वी विल सी इन द कार्डियोवास्कुलर सिस्टम। सो इन प्रीवियस क्लासेस वी हैव सीन द गैस्ट्रो इंटेस्टाइनल सिस्टम, सो नाउ वी आर गोइंग टू सी द कार्डियोवास्कुलर सिस्टम। So before starting the video, please subscribe my channel and like it and share these videos to other people. Okay, let us start the video. Now coming to first anatomy physiology. So in anatomy physiology, so heart and heart wall, we will see first heart and heart wall. So heart, where it is located? It is located in the left side of the mediastinum. So we know left side of the mediastinum. So heart is located in the left side of the mediastinum. Okay, so it consists three layers. So we know three layers. What are they? Epicardium, cardium related with heart. So epi, मायो एंड एंडो. सो एपी इज आउटर, मायो इज मिडिल एंड एंडो फॉर इनर. सो दीज थ्री लेयर्स एक्चुअली हार्ट इज कंसिस्ट. सो एपिकार्डियम, मायोकार्डियम एंड एंडोकार्डियम. सो एपिकार्डियम इज द आउटर मोस्ट लेयर, मायोकार्डियम इज मिडिल लेयर. सो दिस इज मेन इंपॉर्टेंट मायोकार्डियम. व्हाट इज डू? इट इज एक्चुअली कॉन्ट्रैक्टिंग मसल ऑफ द हार्ट. सो हार्ट हैव अ कॉन्ट्रैक्शन. वेन एवर हार्ट इज पंपिंग, सो इट हैज सम कॉन्ट्रैक्शन. सो दिस कॉन्ट्रैक्शन हाउ इट कम्स, इट हाउ विच वॉल्स प्ले अ वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट रोल इन कॉन्ट्रैक्शन, सो दैट इज मायोकार्डियम. सो क्वेश्चन में कम विच लेयर ऑफ हार्ट प्ले इंपॉर्टेंट रोल इन द कॉन्ट्रैक्शन ऑफ हार्ट. सो दे विल गिव द ऑप्शन एपिकार्डियम, मायोकार्डियम, एंडोकार्डियम. So you have to put the answer myocardium. So myocardium has a great role to contracting muscles of the heart. Now endocardium. Endocardium is the innermost layer and the lines, inner chambers and heart walls. So that inner sides, whatever chambers and heart walls is there, it is made up of by endocardium. So these three layers are there. Now coming to pericardial sac. So what is pericardial sac? So there will be a sac will be there, in that heart is protected. So there will be two layers in the pericardium. So there will be two types of pericardium. One will be parietal pericardium, another will be visceral pericardium. So what it do mainly in case, it protects the heart from the trauma and infection. So this pericardium, what it do? It does the protect the from the trauma and infection to the heart. So it is protect the heart from the trauma and infection. So it has a two layer, one is parietal pericardium and one another visceral pericardium. Parietal pericardium is the tough fibrous outer membrane that attaches anteriorly to the lower half of the sternum and posteriorly to thoracic vertebra and inferiorly to diaphragm. So this parietal pericardium attached to the anteriorly where lower half to the sternum and posteriorly to thoracic vertebra and inferiorly to diaphragm. And visceral pericardium is the thin inner layers closely adheres to the heart. So this is the inner layer of the heart. So this is the inner layer of the pericardium. So this is what is, it is attached to the directly to the heart. In between, one cavity will be there. In these two layers, visceral and parietal pericardium, there will be a space. In that space we say pericardial space. That space is called pericardial space. So what it does, this pericardial space? So in between parietal and visceral layers, it holds 5 to 20 mL of pericardial fluids. So it contains pericardial fluids. So whatever gap is there, like this is parietal pleura, this is visceral pleura, this is heart only here. So in this, some fluids will be there, some liquid will be there, that will be 15 to 20 ml. So why it is needed? It lubricates the pericardial surface and cushion of the heart. So whenever any trauma is there, so it will just push backward in direction, so it prevents the further injury to the heart. So for that only this fluid is needed. So it will be how much ml? This is the question. How much ml of pericardial fluid will be there? 5 to 20 ml. It can be 5 to 20 ml. Okay. There are four chambers. So if option comes like this, how much ml of fluids, pericardial fluids will be there? 5 ml, 10 ml, 15 ml, and 20 ml. So you need to put the answer 20 ml, because maximum fluids, how much it will be? 20 ml. So there are four chambers of hearts. So what are they? Right atrium will be there, right atrium, left atrium, right ventricular, and left ventricular. So there are four chambers in the heart. So right atrium receives the deoxygenated blood from the body via superior and inferior vena cava. So this is the diagram of heart. I'll show you like simple diagram. I'm 1 minute. So this is the diagram of heart. So this is the right atrium, this is left atrium, this is right ventricle, this is left ventricle. So what it will be do? In right atrium, here will be one superior vena cava, here it will be inferior vena cava. This is IVC, this is SVC. So these SVC bring the blood from the upper part of the body. Okay, or this IVC bring the blood from the lower part of the body. These two open in the right atrium. Okay, so right atrium receive the deoxygenated blood. So this SVC veins, this is a vein. So vein, we know it carries the deoxygenated blood. So SVC, superior vena cava and inferior vena cava, both opens into the right atrium and it carries the deoxygenated blood. Now coming to right ventricle. So from the right, when blood come into the right atrium, so it has to go to the right ventricle. It came in right atrium, then it has to go to the left ventricle. So how it will go? There will be one valve will be there, like that is tricuspid valve. So in right ventricle, what are the things will be there? In right ventricles, blood from the right atrium and pumps into the lungs via pulmonary artery. So in right ventricle, right ventricle receives blood from the right atrium and pumps into the lungs via pulmonary arteries. So I hope you would understand. So I will make a diagram and I will say. So like this is the ventricle. So this is the right ventricle. So here will be pulmonary artery. So pulmonary artery, what it will, so whatever blood is coming from the right atrium to the right ventricle, so this is the deoxygenated blood. So it will go to the by the pulmonary artery to the lungs. So here lungs will be there, so in lungs it will go. So here it will be oxygenated, then again it will come to the right atrium. So this will be the left atrium. So it will come to the left atrium, then left ventricle, then again pump into the aorta, then it will be sent to the systematic circulation. So this is right ventricle. Then coming to left atrium. So left atrium, what are the things is there in left atrium? So left atrium receives the oxygenated blood from the lungs via four pulmonary veins. So pulmonary veins will bring the deoxygenated blood from the lungs, okay, into the left atrium. Then after left atrium, blood will come to the left ventricles. Left ventricle is the largest and most muscular chamber. So this is very important point. So in our heart, which chamber is most largest and muscular chamber, most muscular chamber? That is the left ventricle. So left ventricle is most largest and muscular chamber. So it receives the oxygenated blood from the lungs via left atrium. and pumps blood into the systematic circulation by aorta. So I already told, so this is the, like this is the left atrium and this is the left ventricle. So here aorta will be there. So aorta, this it will send to the blood to the organs or systematic circulation. Okay, so these are the parts of the heart. Now what are the valves? So valves are there in the heart. So there are four valves is there in the heart. So two atrioventricular valves will be there. Atrioventricular valves means this is atria, this is ventricle. So in between this there will be valves. So that we say atrioventricular valve. So the atrioventricular valves lies between the atria and ventricle. So what are they? So that are tricuspid valves is located on the right side of the heart. So right atrium and right ventricle, in between this tricuspid valve will be there. And bicuspid valve, it will be it is called as mitral valve also. It is located in the left side of the heart. This everything we know, this is common thing. And the atrioventricular valve closes the beginning of the ventricular contraction. So when it is closed is whenever when ventricle contraction occurs, that time atrioventricular valve is closed. Why? If it is, it will not be closed, then backflow will be there into the atria. So that's why atrioventricular valve is closed at the time of ventricular contraction, and the prevents that I said, and the prevent the blood from flow back into the atria from the ventricle. These valves open when the ventricle relax. So when ventricles are relaxed during the ventricular filling, these valves will be open. So whatever blood is there in the right atrium and left atrium, it will come to the ventricles. In that time it will, this valve will open. And whenever ventricles are contracting, so this valve will be closed. Okay, so these are the tricuspid and bicuspid valves. So another name for this atrioventricular valves. So these are two, tricuspid and bicuspid. So remaining two valves are, these are two semilunar valves. So one will be the pulmonic, one will be the aortic. So semilunar valve is pulmonic and aortic. So pulmonic semilunar valve lies between the right ventricle and pulmonary artery. So this, there will be a pulmonary artery, in that pulmonary artery and right ventricle. So right ventricle and pulmonary artery will go to the lungs. So here will be a valve will be there in right ventricular and pulmonary artery. So this valve we say pulmonic semilunar valve. Okay, so which lies in the right between the right ventricle and pulmonary artery. The aortic valve, then aortic valve semilunar valve lies between the left ventricle and aorta. So in left ventricle and aorta there will be aortic semilunar valve. Okay, semilunar valve prevents the blood from the flowing back into the ventricle. So there atrioventricular valve was preventing the blood backflow into the atrium. In this, semilunar valve prevent the blood backflow into the ventricles during relaxation time. So when during relaxation and open during ventricular contraction. So when it will be open, it will be open on the when ventricular contraction will be there. So whatever blood is there in ventricle, it will be filled into the aorta and pulmonary artery. So what the, whatever blood is there, it will be contracted and it will be passed into the that pulmonary artery and aorta, and this valve will be open. So when these valves will be open, then only blood can pumped. If it will be closed, the blood will not go. Okay, so these are the physiology, normal physiology. So SA node. So what is the SA node? So SA node is the main pacemaker and initiate each heartbeat. So whatever heart contraction is there, so how it is occurring, so who is creating this? So there is a SA node, sinoatrial node. So SA node initiates the each heartbeat. Okay, it is located, where it is located? It is located at the junction of superior vena cava and the right atrium. So where superior vena cava comes and the right atrium junction will be there, in that junction this SA node will be present. It will initiate the electrical impulses. दिस एसी नोड जनरेट्स द इलेक्ट्रिकल इम्पल्सेस एट वाट रेट 60 to 100 टाइम्स पर मिनट. सो इन 1 मिनट 60 to 100 टाइम्स पर मिनट दे विल इट विल जनरेट द इलेक्ट्रिकल इम्पल्सेस एंड इट इज़ कंट्रोल्ड बाय सिंपथेटिक एंड पैरासिम्पथेटिक नर्वस सिस्टम. सो हु कंट्रोल दिस? दिस कंट्रोल्ड बाय सिंपथेटिक एंड पैरासिम्पथेटिक नर्वस सिस्टम. देन कमिंग टू एट्रियो वेंट्रिकुलर नोड. सो ए वी नोड, एट्रियो वेंट्रिकुलर नोड इज लोकेटेड लोअर एस्पेक्ट ऑफ द एट्रियल सेप्टम. सो दिस इज लाइक दिस इज द एट्रियम. सो हेयर विल बी द एस ए नोड एंड लाइक दिस हेयर हेयर विल बी द ए वी नोड. सो ए वी नोड इज द लोअर एस्पेक्ट ऑफ द एट्रियल सेप्टम. सो वेन लोअर एस लाइक हेयर, सो दिस इज द लोअर पार्ट ऑफ द एट्रिया, राइट एट्रियम. सो हेयर इट विल बी लोकेट दैट एट्रियो वेंट्रिकुलर node and it receive the impulse from the AC node. So AC node will send the impulse to the AV node. So here will be AC node, so here will be AV node. So this AC node is generating impulse and it will be sent to the AV node. Then AV node, then AC node, this is very important point here, if AC node fails to generate the impulse, then what will happen? Then AV node can initiate and sustain heart rate 40 to 60 beats per minute. What will happen when SA node is not working? Then heart has to initiate the impulse for contraction. So who will do this? Then it will take this SA node's work, AV node. AV node will take SA node's work and it will start to initiate electrical impulses. So at what rate? It will start at the 40 to 60 beats per minute, whereas AC node was starting at AC node was electrical impulses initiating at rate 60 to 100. So whereas AV node, it will start with the 40 to 60 beats per minute. Now coming to, then after AC nodes, it will go through into the bundle of his. So there will be a bundle. So a continuation of AV node. So AV node here, AV node is there. So AV node continues the impulse to the bundle of his. So a continuation of AV node located at the interventricular septum. So where ventricles are divided. So these two ventricles are divided. So this AV node will be here. AV node will give to the bundle of his. So here one bundle, this is right bundle, this is left bundle. So it is transferred is here and here. So these are the bundle of his. So it branches into a right bundle branch which extend to down to the right side of the interventricular septum and left bundle branch which extend to the left ventricular septum. The right and left bundle branches terminate into the Purkinje fiber. So these whatever this left, right and left, it will be terminated into the Purkinje fiber. So there will be some fibers like structure that we say Purkinje fiber. This Purkinje fiber, what it will do? Purkinje fibers are diffuse network of conducting strands located beneath the ventricular endocardium. So it will be located into the endocardium of the ventricles. Okay, so there they will provide the impulses to the endocardium of the ventricular parts. So for contraction. Okay, these fibers spread the waves of depolarization through the ventricles. Okay, so Purkinje fibers can act as a pacemaker with the rate of 20 to 40. When SA node, AB node is not working and bundle of his are not working, so it will then Purkinje fibers start to initiate the impulses. At what rate? It will start to 20 to 40 beats per minute when higher pacemaker such as SA and AV nodes fails. So when SA and AV nodes are not working, it will take their work and it will start to beats at the 20 to 40 beats per minute. Now coming to coronary arteries. So coronary arteries, so where are there two main coronary arteries? One is right main coronary artery, one is left main coronary artery. So right main coronary artery supplies the right side atrium, supplies blood to the right side of atrium and ventricle and inferior portion of the left ventricle and posterior septal wall and the SA node and AV node. So right artery, where it will be? So it will be located at the right, like this is the heart. So here right side, whole right side and some posterior septal wall, it will provide. So it will provide the blood supply to your right atrium, right ventricle, and inferior portion of the left ventricle. So this inferior portion will be there of the left ventricle. So it will be also provided by the right main coronary artery and posterior septal wall and the SA node and AV node. The left main coronary artery, this is important point here, left main coronary artery has two major branches. It has a two major branches. What are they? That is left descending artery, LAD, and one will be the circumflex artery. So there are two branches. One is LAD, left anterior descending artery. Another one is circumflex artery. So left anterior descending artery supplies the blood to the anterior wall of the left ventricle. So it supplies the blood to whom? It supplies the blood to the left. It supplies the blood to the anterior wall of the left ventricle. So anterior wall of the left ventricle and anterior ventricular septum and apex of the heart left ventricles. Okay, where circumflex, what it do? Circumflex supplies the blood to the left atrium, lateral and posterior surface of the left ventricle. So it will supply the left atrium, lateral and posterior. So whereas LAD supplies the left ventricle, anterior and the apex of the heart. So here one important point comes. The coronary artery supplies the capillaries of the myocardium with blood. If blockage occurs in these arteries, if blockage is occur in these arteries, client is at risk of myocardial infarction, MI. So whenever clotting is occurred in the coronary artery, whether it is a right coronary artery or left coronary artery or any LAD or circumflex, so whatever it is, if any blocking is there, so patient is risk for MI, myocardial infarction. So this is aorta. So here you can see this is aorta, this one is aorta, this is left main coronary artery. So this is left coronary artery, this is right coronary artery. This right left coronary artery will divide into LAD and circumflex. Okay, and this is the posterior descending coronary artery, this is the posterior descending coronary artery, and this one is the right marginal coronary artery, and these are the peripheral branches. So whatever you are seeing here, this is the peripheral branches. Now coming to heart sounds. So what are the heart sounds are there? So there will be, you know, S1 and S2 main two sounds will be there. These are normal sounds. So heart sounds. So S1, first heart sound, and S1 is heard at the atrioventricular walls closes. So when we can hear this S1 heart sound? When atrioventricle, when AV valve is closed. So when which valve is closed? AV valve, whether it is tricuspid and bicuspid, the both valve is closed. So then you can hear the S1 sound. When you can hear the S2 sound? When semilunar valve is closes, then we can hear the what? S2 sounds. So this S1 sound is loudest at the apex of heart. So we can hear the this S1 sound is the loudest at the apex of heart. So it will be loudest at the apex of heart, whereas S2 sound will be the loudest as the base of the heart. Now coming to a third sound, S3. So S3 may be heard if ventricular wall compliances is decreased and structures in the ventricular wall vibrates. So when we can hear the S3 heart sound? So when ventricles are not contracted fully, okay, not contracted fully, it's just vibrating. So that time, or in that time, what will happen? Ventricle cannot pump the blood forcefully. It will not pump the fully blood pump. Then it will not pump the whole blood. So that time we can hear the S3 sounds. Okay, so this can occur in conditions such as heart failure. When heart failure is there or valvular regurgitation is there, at that time we can here. So heart failure means when ventricles are not able to pump the blood. So that time we can hear the S3 sounds. And however, a third sound may be normal in individuals younger than 30 years. So in 30 years of age, younger than 30 years of age, people are there in that it can be a normal sound. So now coming to the fourth sound, that is S4. So it can be heard on the atrial systole. So it can be heard on the atrial systole. When atria is contracted, that time it can be heard. If resistance to ventricular filling, so when atria is contracting, so it whenever atria is contracting, so their purpose is filling the ventricles. So when resistance is created into the filling of ventricles, that time you can hear the S4 sounds. So any resistance means any thing is preventing the filling to the ventricles. So when resistance come in between this, so what will happen, you can hear the S4 sound. So it is an abnormal finding and they can cause the cardiac hypertrophy, disease and injury, and injury to the ventricular wall. So this is the fourth sound. So I hope you would have understood these sounds. Now coming to heart rate. So what is heart rate? So fast heart rate is how much it is contracting and filling, and what is the cardiac outputs. So these are the heart rate, how it works. The faster heart rate, the less time the heart has for filling and cardiac output decreases. So that means if HR is more, if HR is more and less time the heart has for filling, so when heart is contracting so much in this, so it will in that filling will not be properly, so ventricle filling will not be proper. So what will happen when filling is not proper, then cardiac output also will decrease. When what will happen when heart is beating fast, it is not pumping the blood fully, it is that's AV node. From the AV node blood will come to the ventricle. So what will happen when heart is beating fast, so that time what will happen, this blood is not coming fully to the ventricle. So when it is not coming full to the ventricle, then how it can make the cardiac output more. So when less filling will be there, so cardiac output also it will decrease. So this is the reason for whenever faster heart rate is there, cardiac output will be decreased. So what is normal sinus heart rate? That is 60 to 100. If more than 100, it will be a sinus tachycardia. If it is less than 60, it will be a sinus bradycardia. Now coming to autonomic nervous system. So what is the role of autonomic system in the heart? So it stimulates the sympathetic nerve fibers, release the neurotransmitter. Stimulation of sympathetic nervous system. So whenever stimulation of sympathetic nervous system, neurotransmitter will be released. What is that? That is norepinephrine. So sympathetic is related with norepinephrine. So whenever sympathetic nervous system is stimulated, norepinephrine will be released and producing an increased heart rate. So epinephrine will release and heart rate will be increased. So increased conduction speed through the AV nodes. So in this condition, norepinephrine will be released. So what it will do, it will increase the heart rate. In that time, conduction speed through the AV node, it will be increased. And what will be happen, the ventricular increase the atrial and ventricular contractility. So it will increase the atrial and ventricular contractility. So then what will happen, peripheral vasocontraction will be there and stimulation occurs when decrease in pressure is detected. So in this condition, what will happen when pressure is decreased in the vessels, when pressure is decreased, so what the one signal will go to the sympathetic nervous system, it will stimulate the norepinephrine, releasing of norepinephrine. So when norepinephrine will release, then it will increase the heart rate. Then heart rate will increase, then cardiac output or cardiac contractility will also increase. Or then one more thing it will do, it will do the peripheral vasoconstriction. When peripheral vasoconstriction will be there, then BP will be increased. So pressure will increased. So this is the function of systematic nervous system. That stimulation of parasympathetic nerve fibers, how it will stimulate? When BP is increased, when BP is increased, then what will happen? Parasympathetic nerve system will work, then it will release the neurotransmitter acetylcholine. Acetylcholine, what is the? It decreases the heart rate. So where is norepinephrine? It increases the heart rate, and acetylcholine is decrease the heart rate. So this is very important point here. Norepinephrine will increase the heart rate, and acetylcholine decrease the heart rate. So when BP is less, so which neurotransmitter will work? Norepinephrine. When BP is high, so which will work? This is acetylcholine. So these two you have to remember. So which decrease the heart rate? So acetylcholine is the decrease the heart rate and lessen the atrial and ventricular contractility. So whenever it is releasing, so it will decrease the atrial and ventricular contractility, then cardiac output will decrease, then further BP will also decrease. Why? Because blood volume also has decreased. So blood volume will decrease and BP will also decrease. So I hope you would have understood. One more time we will see this. I will explain in simple way. When BP is decreased, so what will happen? It will stimulate the sympathetic nervous system. When sympathetic nervous system is stimulated, norepinephrine will be released. So what will be it will do? It will increase the heart rate. That means heart contraction. When contraction will be there, then it will increase the cardiac output. When cardiac output is increased, that means blood volume is increased in the vessels. So when blood volume is increased, automatically BP will be increased. So this is the function of sympathetic nerve fibers. And coming to parasympathetic nerve fiber, what it will do? When BP is increased, when BP is high, so it then parasympathetic nerve fibers will stimulate. What it will do? It will release the acetylcholine. Then acetylcholine will decrease the heart rate. Like it is ulta of this that. So it will decrease the heart rate. Then what it will do? Then atrial and ventricular contractility will be decreased. Then cardiac output will decrease. Then what will happen? Cardiac output will CO is decreased cardiac output. Then blood volume also decrease. Then what it will do? Automatically BP will also go down. So this is the normal physiology of autonomic nervous system. Now coming to BP control. So how it can be controlled? First is baroreceptor. So baroreceptor is specialized nerve ending affected by changes in the atrial BP, also called pressoreceptor. So there will be a specialized nerve ending that is affected. A nerve ending affected by changing in the atrial. When atrial BP is affected, changes is there. So nerve acting that baroreceptor will be affected. How? Also called pressoreceptor, and it will be located into the walls of aortic arch and carotid sinus. So it will be located into the wall of aortic arch and carotid sinus. So this is important point here. So where it will be located, baroreceptor? It will be located at the aortic arch and carotid sinus. So increased atrial pressure stimulate the baroreceptor. So whenever atrial pressure is increased, so it will stimulate the baroreceptor and heart rate and atrial pressure decrease. So what it will do? So heart rate and atrial pressure will be decreased when baroreceptor is stimulated. Decrease in atrial pressure reduce the stimulation of baroreceptor. So when it has decreased, so stimulation of baroreceptor will be also decreased, and vasoconstriction will occur due to increase in heart rate. So in that, what will happen? When decrease in atrial pressure reduce stimulation of baroreceptor. When atrial pressure is what? It is decreased. So when atrial pressure is decreased, baroreceptor stimulation also will be reduce, it will be also decrease. Then what will happen? Vasoconstriction will occur. Vasoconstriction will occur. So what it will do when vasoconstriction will occur, it will increase the heart rate. Okay, this is the normal physiology. Then coming to stretch receptor, what it will do, located in the vena cava. So it is located in the vena cava and right atrium. So vena cava, it is located in the vena cava, superior and inferior vena cava and right atrium. Responds to the pressure changes that affect the circulatory volume, blood volume. So what it will do, it is responds to the pressure changes that affect the circulatory volume. So where it will work, when pressure changes occur, so what will be happen, circulatory volume, so it will be affect to the circulatory volume, that means whatever volume is flowing in the blood vessels. When BP decreases, this is important point here, when BP decreases as a result of hypovolemia, so when bleeding is there, okay, bleeding is there, so hypovolemia will be there. When hypovolemia will be there, BP will fall down. Then what will happen, in that case it will increase the heart rate. So heart wants to pump the more blood to the organs, so heart's work will be increased. So it will increase the heart rate and blood vessels, and blood vessels constriction, so heart will also contract more and blood vessel constriction will hold. So when BP is increased as a result of hypervolemia, opposite effect will occur. So see, when hypovolemia is there, so BP will be fall down. So when BP will be fall down, so what will happen, vasoconstriction will occur and plus heart rate will increase. Heart rate will also increase to increase the BP. When opposite effect is there, when BP is increased, why BP is increased, when hypervolemia is there, so what it will do, BP will be increased. So when BP will be increased, so vasodilation will be there. What will be there, vasodilation, and heart contraction will decrease. So when heart contraction will decrease, so blood volume also will decrease, then it will lead to the, it will decrease the BP. So this is the normal physiological process. So when, remember 2-6, vasoconstriction means increase BP, and vasodilation means decrease BP. Okay, hypervolemia increase BP, hypovolemia decrease BP. So these are the things. So what are the another effects of BP? One more, antidiuretic hormone. So antidiuretic hormone vasopressin, it influences the BP indirectly by regulating vascular volume. So what it will do, it is have a indirectly effect on the BP. How? When increase in the blood volume result in the decreased antidiuretic hormone release. So when blood volume is increased, so when blood volume is increased, so antidiuretic hormone ADH will not release. So when increasing diuresis, decreasing blood volume, thus decrease the BP. So what it is saying, increase in the blood volume result in decreasing antidiuretic hormone. Okay, when blood volume has increased, so it will lead to a decreasing antidiuretic hormone and increasing diuresis. So what will happen when blood volume has increased, so what it will do, ADH will not be released, so diuresis will occur, that means patient will have a more urine. Okay, patient will pass the more urine, because diuresis will occur, because antidiuretic means it consists in conserve the water, antidiuretic means it stop the urination. So when it will not release, then increase diuresis will occur, then BP will fall down, decrease the blood volume, thus decrease BP. So what it will do, blood volume will decrease and then BP will also decrease. So this is the physiology. Now opposite of this, decrease in blood volume, so सो व्हेन ब्लड वॉल्यूम इज डिक्रीज सो एंटी डायबिटिक हार्मोन विल रिलीज. सो एंटी डायबिटिक हार्मोन विल बी रिलीज, व्हाट इट विल डू, इट विल प्रमोट एन इंक्रीजिंग ब्लड वॉल्यूम. सो व्हाट इट विल डू, इट विल कंजर्व द वाटर इनसाइड द बॉडी. The when it will conserve the water inside the body, then blood volume will increase, then automatically BP will also increase. So this is the normal physiology. Here one more point is renin. Renin is a potent vasoconstrictor, causes the BP to increase. So when BP is fall down, so renin will be released in the kidney. So what it will do, it will do the vasoconstriction, okay, to increase the BP. So renin, what it will do, renin converts angiotensin to angiotensin 1, converted into the angiotensin 1, and angiotensin 1 is converted into the angiotensin 2 in the lungs. Okay, so one is angiotensinogen is converted into the one is in kidney, and this one is converted into the two into the lungs. So this is important point also, can ask where it will be converted. So you have to give the answer lungs. Then angiotensin second. So angiotensin second stimulates the release of aldosterone. So when angiotensin second is converted, that means angiotensin 2 is ready. So what it will do, it will stimulate the release of aldosterone. So aldosterone will be released, and what it will be do, it will promote the water and sodium retention by the kidney. Then it will increase the blood volume, then automatically BP will be increased. So angiotensinogen will work on the aldosterone. So this is important point here. So this is very important. Okay. Now coming to vascular changes. So what will be there in vascular changes? Arteries are vessels through which the blood passes away from the heart to the various part of the body. They convey high oxygenated blood from the left side of the heart to the tissue. So artery takes the high oxygenated blood to the peripheral organs. So artery, what is the main artery is taken? So that is aorta. So aorta will take blood from the left ventricle to the peripheral tissues. So that will be the oxygenated. So artery is considered oxygenated blood, and arterioles control the blood flow into the capillary. So there will be arterioles that flows, that control the blood flow into the capillary. So minor capillaries will be there, in that blood flow is controlled by the arterioles. Now capillaries allows the exchange of fluid and nutrients between the blood and interstitial space. So this is very important. So who controls the blood and nutrition, fluid and nutrition exchange in the blood and interstitial space? It is controlled by the capillaries. So capillaries allow the exchange of fluid and nutrition between the blood and interstitial space. So blood and so there will be exchange in between blood and interstitial space. Venule receives the blood from the capillary bed and moves blood into the veins. So venules will work on the veins. So veins transport the deoxygenated blood to the, from how it will be, so veins will take to the right heart, that means right atrium, from IVC and SVC, that will take, then after that right atrium to right ventricular, and there will be a pulmonary artery, it will take to the lungs, their blood will get oxygenated, then again it will go to the left atrium, then left ventricle, then aorta will take to the systematic circulation. Walls helps to return blood to the heart against the force of gravity. So walls helps return blood to the heart. So there will be wall will be there in veins. So in veins wall will be there. So what they will do, they will push the blood to the forward direction and prevent the blood to back flow. So that's why it will push into the, where, in the right atrium. And one more important point is here, the lymphatic drain the tissues and return tissue fluid to the blood. So lymphatic drain the tissues and return to the tissue fluid into the blood. So lymphatic drain will be there into a tissue, that tissue fluid will return to the blood. So whatever tissue is fluid is collected, it will directly mixed into the ब्लड, सो दैट इज़ द लिम्फेटिक ड्रेनेज सिस्टम. सो दिस वर द सम एनाटॉमी एंड फिजियोलॉजी. सो इन दिस वीडियो दिस मच ओनली. इन डायग्नोस्टिक प्रोसीजर एंड ऑल वी विल सी इन द नेक्स्ट वीडियो. सो थैंक यू ऑल ऑफ यू. प्लीज़ सब्सक्राइब माई चैनल. If you don't understand, if you have any query, please comment on comment box. If you have not understanding because time is very less, I have to make so fast, so I am going fast only. You see, you watch the video again and again, so you will understood what I am going to say, what I am trying to say, because I have to finish this whole NCLEX. Okay, thank you everyone. We will meet in next video. Thank you.